to reduce the defects. How do we reduce defects? By reducing the variations. Where we need to reduce the variation? We need to understand CTQs. What are CTQs? The critical to quality characteristics. Nothing but the numbers that drive customer satisfaction. Nothing but the number that actually drive the customer satisfaction. This could be your product specification, or it could be your process parameter, or it could be the input that goes into your process. So nothing but some number. When I optimize the number, customer satisfaction will improve. So that number, such numbers are called CTQs, critical to quality characteristics. I'll see to that the CTQ matrix never changes. If CTQ metric never changes, my customer satisfaction also never changes. So that is the logic. There are two approaches we understood. One is DMAC, another one is DMADV. The DMAC is to reduce the defects and to improve the process. DMADV for new product development. And for new product development is otherwise called as design for Six Sigma. Right. And now let us understand Six Sigma in the context of, let us say, a call taxi service, right? Hope all of you know call taxi service, right? Like Ola, Uber, and then in your country, there might be some such service. When you book a car will come within the stipulated time. It is like your online food delivery system. We have online car booking. And now, what is process capability here with respect to the call taxi kind of service? Every time when you open the mobile application and book a car, the mobile application will show you some information. The car will arrive in 30 minutes. The car will arrive in 30 minutes. And if the car doesn't arrive on time, tell me how much time you will tolerate. Can somebody answer this question? You have booked a car, and the app says the car will arrive in 30 minutes. How much time will you tolerate delay?
5 minutes, 10 minutes.
Okay. 5 to 10 minutes. You will, very good. 5 to 10 minutes, you will tolerate. It can be either side, plus or minus. If I book a car for 30 minutes, if it comes immediately, and then also I may not use. And that way it is lost to the company. There is no point making the car simply wait in front of your house. You are not going to pay. So 30 plus or minus 10 minutes. Whenever the app says car will come in 30 minutes, the target is 30, and then there will be tolerance of plus or minus 10 minutes. Okay, so fine. Now, so see here, when you are running a company like this kind of services, call taxi service or food delivery service or anything online delivery, right? When customer expectation is 30 means up to 30 minutes, customer is ready to accept your product. But beyond 30, maybe some customer might wait for extra 10 minutes, some kind customer might wait for extra 5 minutes, and somebody might cancel right after 30 minutes. You said you will send a car in 30 minutes, but now it is already 32 minutes. So I'm going to cancel the order. Even if the car comes, they will send it back. That means the rejections will be possible beyond certain point. So as a service provider, I'm going to consider the situation like this, 20 plus or minus 10. That means the targeted time to send my car is within 20 minutes. And at the maximum, my car can take 30 minutes to reach the customer. In case if my car goes early, it can be 10 minutes prior to the targeted time. So now what is USL and what is LSL in this case? Can somebody tell me? What is USL and what is LSL?
20 minutes and 40 minutes.
20 and 40.
20 and 40. How?
20, 10 and 30.
10 and 30.
10 and 30.
10 and 30. Right?
Yeah. So at the earliest, the car can reach in 10 minutes. And in the worst, car can reach in 30 minutes. That means we are targeting our business process in such a way that car reaches the customer in 20 minutes. Whenever they book for the app says 30 minutes, our car will actually arrive in 20 minutes. And in that way only we developed our network. the number of cars in a particular pin code and everything we arrange in such a way that this happens. So this is called a process capability. When you don't have sufficient number of cars or when you don't have properly trained drivers, and you will struggle to meet this requirement, and finally most of your orders might get cancelled. So our ability to send cars within 20 plus or minus 10 minutes is called a process capability. I have visualized the specification limits in this case. 30 is the USL, 10 is the LSL. That means the target is 20. All of you understand specification bit, right? I hope everybody understand. And now I really want to understand whether my process can meet the customer requirement. Customer requirement is this. Now, what is this? This is my process. In a particular pin code, I have so many number of cars, so many number of trained drivers, and every car is equipped with the GPS system. And there are many things I do. Ultimately, I wanted to know whether my process I designed is capable of delivering the customer requirement or not. In order to understand, I collect the sample of data pertaining to bookings related to 30 minutes. Let us say there are 100 such bookings. In all those bookings, the time committed by the app is maximum 30 minutes. So I collected the data. Now I wanted to analyze. How do I analyze the data? I calculate average and then I calculate standard deviation. And can you look at the slide and tell me what is the average and what is the standard deviation calculated out of the sample data? What is the average and what is the standard deviation? Come on.
Standard deviation is
3.33. Average is 20. Customer target is generally denoted by the letter mu. Here, our target is 20 minutes. But actual found is denoted by X bar. Actual found means average calculated from your data. I have sample of, let us say, 100 data and average is 20. Sigma is 3.33. Immediately, I calculate control limit. How do I calculate control limit? Average plus 3 sigma. When sigma is 3.33, can somebody tell me how much is 3 sigma? 3 into 3.33, how much?
10.
Oh, my upper control limit is 30, lower control limit is 10. In order to understand whether my process is capable or not, I overlap both. Now I overlapped. I understand my control limit is overlapping with the specification limit. And I know this is process, my data is following normal distribution. We can check easily whether our process follow normal distribution or not. So once I understand my process follow normal distribution, can somebody tell me what percentage of my data will lie inside control limit? We have studied this in the morning. These are control limit, right? Left side is control limit, right side is also control limit. What percentage of data will lie?
99.73.
Very good. So 99.73, that means any data you collect, you calculate average in 3 sigma, you will be definitely surprised to understand 99.73% of your data will fall inside control limit. And that means 99.73% of the data in this case will fall between 10 and 30. That means 99.73% of the time your car has arrived at the customer point between 10 minutes and 30 minutes from the time of booking. This is how your process is currently going on. So that means when you collect the sample properly, your sample can speak about the population. If you collect the sample correctly, your sample can speak about the population. In this example, what is sample? A rough small collection of 100 deliveries, information about 100 car bookings is the sample. What is population? Population is the total bookings that may happen in the same locality. Total booking in a day, total booking in a week, total booking in a month, or total booking in a year. The numbers can be huge, isn't it? When I keep on extending the period. But I want to understand what is going to happen in the next 6 months. But all that I have is some amount of data. When I collect the data properly, this data will help me to understand what is going to happen in my market, right? So 99.73% of the deliveries or booking car arrivals are going to happen between 10 and 30 minutes. Now imagine, currently there are 1,000 bookings happens every single day for your car. Out of 1,000 bookings, how many bookings will happen properly? 99.73%. What is 99.73% of 1,000? How much it is? 997. That means three of the bookings might get cancelled, because only three bookings have the chance of going beyond 30 minutes. So customer might cancel those order. Now tell me, are you happy with the way your car booking and the call taxi business is going on? Are you happy or not happy? Looks happy. Definitely, it looks happy. 997 out of 1,000 is really good. But three bookings are getting cancelled. But what happened when you really do very well? What will happen? More customers will come to your product. Obviously, that will happen, isn't it? When you do very well, more customers will start booking your car. Now, suddenly what happened? Within a month time, you started getting 10,000 bookings every single day. Do you think you will be able to maintain the 99.73% success rate still?
No, yes.
When you are getting 1,000 bookings a day, your success rate is 99.73. Failure rate is only 0.27. Will you be able to maintain the same success rate when you start getting 10,000 orders every single day?
Practically not possible.
Not possible, right? So that means process will always, deteriorate. Though you have a process, there is a tendency to deteriorate. That is what we understood in the morning also. When I increase the demand, your capability will come down, right? Why the capability come down? The process will deteriorate in the sense, you look at the process. This bell-shaped curve. This bell-shaped curve, either the spread will increase too much, or the process, whole process as it is, might move to the right or left. Whole process can move to the right. If the whole process moving to the left, right means center is moving to the right. Another thing is, if the spread increases, my control limit will increase. Already my control limit is touching the specification limit. If the spread further increase, control limit will go beyond specification limit and rejections will be more, right? And now we will talk about the deterioration. Deterioration definitely happened because we can't expect the same thing to happen over a longer term. There will be variation in any business. So now this process can be now called just capable. Why do I use the word just capable? My control limit overlap with the specification limit. That is why I said success rate is 99.73, right? And statistically, this process is also called as 3-sigma process. Statistically, this process is called as 3-sigma. Why do I call it 3-sigma process? Can somebody tell me the distance between the process center? Where is my process center? Process center is here. My nearest specification limit is here. And now tell me, what is the distance between process center and the nearest specification limit? Come on.
3 sigma.
Very good. So the process is called 3-sigma. Now you understand what is the meaning of 3-sigma process. In a 3-sigma process, the success rate is 99.73. But 99.73 applicable only for the current situation. Future situation, when my demand increases, my capability will come down. My capability will definitely come down. 99.73 might drop to 95 or 90 or 85, and there will be some rejections. And now I'm going to give a nickname for this process. Look at the shape of the curve. It looks like an elephant, right? It looks like head of the elephant. So I will call it an elephant process. Why elephant name is given here? We need to understand, we have put a big animal in a very small place. When you put a big animal in a small place, what will happen? It will try to move around. When it tries to move around, it will automatically break the walls, and then damages will be caused. Same way, when you operate the process like this, when you keep the control limit all very, very close to specification limit, due to process deterioration, control limit will move out, or the entire process might move out, right? So let us understand those situations. See here, and right now, do you see my red color triangle here? What this triangle represents? Red color line, red color zone.
Rejection.
Rejections. Because beyond the specification limit, though it is 0.27, these are rejections. But in a long term, what happened? My process can deteriorate, can completely shift. That means the center is shifted from the previous position to somewhere here. You can understand the distance moved is about 1.5 sigma. And generally, this is a thumb rule. Distance will move by amount and equal to an amount equal to 1.5 sigma. As a result, my control limit will also move. Now, what happened? Whatever you are seeing here, can you now understand? This area has, the rejection area now increased to 8 to 10%. That means your 99.73 success rate is not applicable for long term. The 99.73 has dropped down to 89 or something. All of you now understand why the rejections are increasing? Clear?
Yes. Yeah, it's clear. Sure.
Two things. One is process center can move. If you keep the center at the same point, still one more way problem can happen. The spread can increase and control limit can move out. So if you don't want these kind of problems to happen in your business, you must keep an eye on your standard deviation in addition to keeping an eye on the average. Average is at the healthier point. It is on the target. Look at the new standard deviation, 1.66. With the new standard deviation, the new control limit is 25 on the right side and 15 on the left side. And now what this process is now called doubly capable. Why do I call it doubly capable? Customer gave me a tolerance of 10 on both sides. So plus 10 and minus 10. That means over total tolerance is 20, but my process has used only half of it. So I call my process doubly capable. And now this process, I will call it a giraffe process. Why? When I reduce the standard deviation, my control limit is pushed inward. When my control limit is pushed inward, most of my outputs are pushed towards the center. When most of the inputs are pushed towards the center, my graph will grow taller in the center. Only to help you remember this concept, I call this process a giraffe process. Whenever you see a taller curve, a curve taller in the center with a lower spread, this is a giraffe process. That means highly capable process. And this is called a doubly capable. In terms of statistics, again, we will check the sigma level from the center to the nearest specification limit. How much is the sigma level? Can somebody tell me?
Six.
Very good.
Six sigma.
So this is six sigma. Six sigma. Beautiful. So this is six sigma process. Six sigma process, when you run, your success rate will be definitely more than 99.73. Now this will be 99.999. Why do I go beyond 99.73? Because here itself I get 99.73. That is our rule. We understood, isn't it? If this is 99.73, this will be definitely more than 99.73. That is what I'm saying, 99.999. Now tell me, when there are 1,000 car bookings happening every single day, 99.999% of the bookings are properly handled. That means almost all 1,000 bookings are giving you business. No cancellation. There is no cancellation. And now in a long term, what happened? Since you are performing better in a long term, every single day you might get 10,000 bookings. Now think about 99.999% of 10,000. How much that will be 99.999% of 10,000? Can I again write all 10,000? All 10,000. And moreover, the rejections are almost nil. How it is ensuring me, see, my performance or my demand increases from 1,000 to 10,000, but still my rejection levels are still at the same level. How is it happening? Let us consider the process deterioration and see here. This is the rejection area, but I don't put it in red here. Why? Because this is only internal failure, because customer still finds my car on time. But according to my business process, it is a delayed. Something happened. I will inquire my driver. maybe I will take some action, but then also failure is not felt by my customer. That is why it is indicated in yellow. Now my process deteriorates. When my process deteriorates, how much distance the center will move? What is our assumption?
1.5.
Very good.
1.5
sigma it moved. As a result, my control limit also will move by 1.5 sigma. And now what happened? Beyond control limit is this thing. This is the red color area. Anything outside control limit should be considered a failure. We need to understand, right? And though customer finds it useful, we will consider it as internally failure. But now a small percentage is going outside the specification limit. This is what is causing the failure to be at the level of 3.4 DPMO, right? So when you measure this, actually this small area accounts to 3.4 defects per million opportunities. 1 minute. So do you all now understand how we are making our products almost defect free in long term also? By ensuring that our process is centered on the target, by ensuring that our control limits are placed well inside the specification limit. Even something goes wrong, again my control limit can come outside, but then also my customer can't easily detect a failure. The chance we are leaving is very, very less. The chance we are leaving is 0.0001. Very, very low percentage, and so failures are almost rare. And now look at my slide and tell me, what is the sigma level for this process? Is it an elephant or giraffe?
Elephant.
This looks elephant. Like elephant. And now, statistically, what is the sigma level?
Three sigma.
And so what will be the success rate you can expect?
99.73%.
Right. And this 99.73 is applicable for short term or applicable for long term?
Short term.
Only. Long term, when the process shifts or the spread increases, then defects will be more. You can't apply this 99.73. Very good understanding. And now I improve the process. Improving the process means I move the control limit inside. And now tell me, is it still an elephant or a giraffe?
Giraffe.
And now statistically, what is the sigma level?
Six sigma.
And now what will be the success rate now?
99.999.
Beautiful. 99.999%. The failure chance is only 0.001. Right? And now, sometimes your process can be two-tailed, process can be one-tailed. What is one-tailed? In case of car delivery, only when the car arrives after 30 minutes, the failure is felt by the customer. If the car arrives prior to the LSL, let's say car arrives within 2 minutes, is it a failure?
No.
Not a failure.
No.
That means the process is one-tailed process. Failure is possible only on one side. So under such situation, your success rate will be 99.999666. That means the failure chance is very, very low. That is the time the DPMO, the benchmark value, you will be able to see. 3.4 defects per million opportunities. If there are 1 million bookings happening, there will be only 3.4 bookings where you see your car reaching the customer taking more than 30 minutes. If you apply the same logic for a two-tailed process, maybe a dimension where the dimension should be 20 centimeter or something, or 20 millimeter plus or minus some value, then it will be two-tailed. Under such situation, your success rate will be 99.999320, and that means the failures will be somewhere around 6.8. so this is the kind of capability you will achieve when you improve the sigma level beyond 3 sigma. So by looking at the process, you can understand what your process is capable of. If there are too much variation, then it is hard to produce output. Sigma level will be low, yield will be low, defects will be very high. On the other hand, if your process are looking like this, narrower as well as taller, that is like a giraffe, virtually everything you produce will meet the customer requirement. Sigma levels will be very high, yield will also be very high, and rejections will be very, very low. This is what is called a Six Sigma way of problem solving. A real-time problem, a call taxi example we have discussed. You tell me any industry, an example, I will convert into a number problem. So practical problem can be converted into statistical problem. Then for statistical problem, is possible. What is statistical solution? Reduce standard deviation and get your average on the target. These are the statistical solutions. But how do you get it? By working in real time. You need to maybe increase the drivers, or you need to train your drivers, or you need to increase the number of cars. Do something. So practically, when you work, then only your average will move to the target. Then only standard deviation will come down. So this is called the Six Sigma way of problem solving, and that contains five phases: define, measure, analyze, improve, and control. So defining means you have to make the problem measurable. In the case of call taxi example, what is the CTQ we discussed? Can somebody tell me what is our CTQ in this case? In the car example, what is that we monitored?
Monitor
car